Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Dr. Robinson here again. This time we are going on with our study skills series, and we're dedicating this show to this very, very nice young man. And he's going to be dealing with the topic of evaluating algebraic expressions. If you need help with your homework, there's Dial a Teacher Homework Helpline at 212-777-3380, Monday to Thursday, 4 p.m. to 7 p.m. Give them a call. They're very nice people. Don't forget to watch our YouTube videos. My channel name is Dan Robinson, PKMS, Peak Skill Middle School. Subscribe to our channel. Give us a thumbs up if you like what we're doing. Write us a comment. I do write back. Don't forget to check out our latest release, PKMS Math Prep 21. You can tweet me at drobmath1. Don't forget to watch our show Math Time on Tuesdays at 4:30 p.m. to 5 p.m. on Optimum Cable Vision, only in Peekskill on Channel 15. All right, let's get going. So we are going to be talking about evaluating algebraic expressions. So our goal is to figure out what is this expression equal to when you are given a number. So here we have n is equal to 5, and we have this expression 4n squared minus 3n plus 2. So we want to figure out what is that equal to when n is equal to 5. Well, first thing you need to do is the substitute for n. So everywhere you're going to see the letter n, you're going to substitute. Now, what do you mean by substitute, Dr. Rob? Well, substitution in algebra means putting numbers where the letters are using parentheses. So in other words, I'm going to switch place where the letter n is with the number 5 and parentheses. So first thing I'm going to put up is my parentheses so you can see where they go. And I'm covering the n. So that way, now I can substitute in its place the number 5. Where did I get the 5 from? It says it right up here, n is equal to 5. So I substituted for n equal to 5. So the first thing I remember, wherever I see the letter n, I have to substitute it for the number 5, for the number that they gave us where n is equal to. In this case, it is 5. Now, there's some buttons that we need to be familiar with, because we'll be using them a lot. The x squared button, that x with a little 2 there, is right next to the number 7 button. And there's another button that you should be aware of, the exponent button. And that's above the x squared button. So if you have an exponent that's higher than 2 or lower than 2, any number that you want to make it, even if you want to use 2, you can use that button as well. It's called a caret button, because it looks like an upside down V or a carrot when you're eating. So one comment about the x squared button, there is a square root if you press second. So those of you who want to know where is that square root button, if you press second, x squared, that'll give you the square root. Inverse operations. Okay. So now let's get our calculator, Dr. Rob. Let's clear all this stuff out of there. Clear. And now let's type in our work. So we're going to type 4 parenthesis 5 parenthesis x squared button, and let me move over, and minus 3 parenthesis 5 parenthesis plus 2. Now before I press enter, let me check it, see if it looks the same as that there. Good. So I typed in everything the same. So my answer is going to be 87. So let's pull this out. And I typed everything as there. So let's release. Yes, 87. So I got it right. So the calculator can help us. Just remember, type in exactly what you have so the calculator can do the substitution for you. And one quick comment, if you are a subscriber, I did put up a nice trick with math and using math and technology to evaluate expressions. So you might want to take a look at that video as well. So I hope you get what's going on. If you're not sure, rewatch the video and bring in your comments, write them down, and I'll be glad to answer your questions in class. So let's try it again. So this time, let's go over it. Here we have 6x to the third plus 4x squared plus x, a lot of x's there, minus 3 when x is equal to negative 2. So we have a negative integer this time we're using. So we're going to substitute. And remember, we first put up our parenthesis in place of the letter x, right? So it should look like that. Parenthesis around the letter x, because that's where we're going to be doing our substitution. So what am I going to substitute in place of the x? If you said negative 2, you are right. So I'm putting negative 2. Where did you get the negative 2 from, Dr. Rob? All the way over there when x is equal to negative 2. So I substitute negative 2 in place of each one of those x's, and there's a minus 3 at the end. So now all I got to do is get my calculator out, and let's clear that and type all that stuff in there. So let's type 6 parenthesis negative 2. Remember to use the negative button underneath the 3 parenthesis. Now I got to use the caret button to get up, to make this 3 get up there. My calculator is a little bit different, so it puts up 3 very nicely. You would have the caret symbol and then 3, which tells the computer, the calculator, to make that number next to it go up there as an exponent. All right, plus 4 parenthesis. Let's move over a little bit, Dr. Rob. And we got negative 2 parenthesis, x squared button. And let's move to the other side. Plus, and let me move over, plus parenthesis, a lot of typing, negative 2 parenthesis, and minus 3. All right, that looks like everything there. Hopefully I typed it in right. And I get negative 37. So let's pull that out. So negative 37. And in case you wanted to figure out what each one of these terms were by itself, you can definitely do that. And I do get negative 37. And the calculator helped me out again. Great. Good to know that I can use the calculator to help me out. So I hope you understand what's going on. If you're not sure, rewatch the video, write down questions, and bring them in the class. And do I have one for you? Of course. Here's a question for you to evaluate. This time we're using a is equal to 3/4. So you might want to check out that video I made on decimals to deal with fractions. So hope things are going well, because this is the end of our video. So dial a teacher homework helpline. It's 212-777-3380. They're very nice people. And give them a call Monday to Thursday, 4 p.m. to 7 p.m. Don't forget to watch my show on YouTube. My channel name is Dan Robinson, PKMS. Check out our latest release, PKMS Math Prep 21. Give us a thumbs up if you like what we're doing. Write us a comment and let us know how we can even help you even better. And my tweet handle there is tweet me at drobmath1. Watch our show Math Time on Tuesdays from 4:30 p.m. to 5 p.m. on Optimum Cablevision, only in Peekskill on channel 15. If you would like more work on this topic, write me at drobinson@peekskillschools.org. And there's my little Kinsley, just saw her the other day, as a matter of fact. So keep up the good work, Kinsley. And Math Prep 21, the pandemic, good movie, you should check it out. And I want to again thank you for joining us in our study skills series. And we dedicate this show to this very nice young man, Evaluating Algebraic Expressions. So see you next time. Dr. Robinson signing off. Bye-bye.